to this material, you may feel very uncomfortable with that and challenged to confront your prior assumptions about September 11th. If you've already been exposed to these issues, you'll see that there are many things you want to look at. We have a large group of gifted researchers. Some of them have been questioning the official story of 9/11 from the very first day after the attacks. The questions these researchers have raised has been the subject of countless articles, discussions initiated by citizens in their homes. And there's been official silence by the commercial media about these events. But we've had a tremendous impact on what people have thought. Last month, a representative poll commissioned by Zogby found that about half of the city's residents do not believe that the attacks came by surprise. 41% of New York residents. Half.
That's 49.3% of residents of New York City and 41% of New York State residents. And the question is, how could that view be so pervasive? Why have their questions been ignored? We believe we owe it to the victims and their surviving family members to conduct a searching and fearless examination of the events of 9/11 from a number of different angles and to pursue it wherever it leads. We know of no better way to honor the fallen than to marshal our forces, intellectual, emotional, and confront what repels us, dark implications of evidence which it's all too easy to put aside. We hope that as you draw your own conclusions, we can aim together at a more complete account of those events.
If you are among those to whom it seems impossible that the authorities would actually allow 9/11 to happen for political gain at such an enormous cost to human life, consider what the authorities knowingly allowed to happen to the residents of this city immediately after September 11th. Let me please introduce Jenna Orkin of the World Trade Center Environmental Organization. Jenna.
September 11th was a tragedy that has changed the course of history and the way we live. It was also an environmental disaster of historic proportions. The World Trade Center contained about 50,000 computers, each made with between 4 and 12 pounds of lead. That's not including World Trade Center 7. Hundreds of tons of asbestos coated the first 40 stories of at least one tower. The tens of thousands of fluorescent light bulbs each contained enough mercury to contaminate a quarter of a city block. The smoke detectors contained radioactive americium-241. The alkalinity of the air particles was equivalent to that of Drano. A month after the disaster, scientists from the University of California at Davis found levels of vanadium and very and ultrafine particles that were the highest they'd ever seen of 7,000 samples taken from around the world, including at the burning Kuwaiti oil fields. Dr. Marjorie Clark has testified that 9/11 was equivalent to dozens of asbestos factories, incinerators, and crematoria, as well as a volcano. Yet starting on September 13th, the EPA maintained, "The air is safe to breathe." A report by the EPA Inspector General in August of 2003 revealed that EPA's press releases, which initially warned the public about asbestos in the air, were edited to offer reassurances instead. The editing was performed by the White House Council on Environmental Quality in order to reopen Wall Street. That's in the report. As a result of the false good news, rescue workers were sometimes not allowed to wear respirators on the grounds that they might frighten the public. Insurance companies often refused to pay for cleanup, forcing residents to clean the tons of toxic debris in their apartments as per the instructions from the New York City Department of Health. Use a wet mop or wet rag, and where the dust is really bad, wear long pants. We are beginning to see the consequences of this disastrous chain of events. Over half of the heroes who cleaned Ground Zero are already manifesting serious respiratory problems. Hundreds of firefighters can no longer work. And as a harbinger of what's in store for people, 14 rescue dogs have died. The commission report deals with this issue in a footnote on page 555. They interviewed Sam Thernstrom, the White House coordinator who changed the press releases. He said his motive wasn't to reopen Wall Street, it was procedural. His story is corroborated by Christy Todd Whitman, who told the initial lies. When John Gotti is corroborated by Lucky Luciano, that may be good enough for the commission. We should not rest there. In the environmental disaster of 9/11, Osama bin Laden could not have found a better collaborator, a more kindred spirit than George W. Bush.
We can reassure the public that the air is safe to breathe, the water is safe to drink.
EPA officials were lying to the public and to Congress about the health effects engendered by the 9/11 catastrophe.
Because the EPA said the offices were safe and employers ordered their employees back into these buildings, and thousands of us are now permanently ill.
I headlined at Radio City Music Hall with the Rockettes dancing behind me. I sang everywhere there was to sing a song, but I can't sing now because every time I try to sing now, I choke.
So in the middle of October, October 15, 2001, I came to work. 2 days later, I woke up at night, October 17, 2001, and my lungs were full and gurgling. The respiratory function was so low that it woke me up out of a sound sleep. And from that day on, I've been sick.
In fact, the air was hazardous for many, many months, and all those tons of hazardous material were lodged in people's homes, in their offices, where in many cases they still are today.
I think the major failure by the U.S. government after 9/11 was its failure to act as a government. As the government should be, and that is to inform and to protect.
Of all the